What's up, friends? How you doing? Well, I hope. Today we have a new video. If you didn't see yesterday's video, which was a vlog because it was Sunday, made a major announcement. I'm very, very nervous, and I hope you guys will stick with me, be with me. I, Kelly, am going to be uploading 3 times a week. Why? Well, one, I want to be more consistent. I want us to grow together. I have so many fun video ideas that I'm like not making, and I don't want to be lazy about YouTube. So I figure if I create a schedule that I can stick to, I hope, pray for me. This video is a haul. I'm gonna do a collective haul of indie designers. I know we all know about the Lane Bryants and the Torrids and, you know, those big companies that we see that have advertising dollars and have been around forever. But there's a lot of up and coming or well-established indie brands that just don't get kind of in the general consciousness of plus size shoppers. I'm gonna feature a bunch of indie designers that I love that have sick pieces, starting with the one that I have on. Dress, I'm obsessed, and it's so funny because I think the 3 of the dresses I'm going to show you, they're all like a maxi style, not on purpose, just a coinky dink. But the first designer I'm going to talk about is Melissa Massey. If you follow me, you know she's a very good friend of mine. She's based here in LA, the clothes are made in LA. She is chef's kiss, an amazing human being, and I love her clothes. So the cool thing about Melissa is that she does everything extra, extra small to 3X, 4X, and she does custom made to measure. So no matter what size you are, you can definitely find something. She sells it like Bloomingdale's and Neiman Marcus. It's definitely in the entry point of luxury. So it's accessible, but it's not like Gucci prices. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, I'm wearing this dress. I love it so much. It's prairie. It has this really cute pussy bow on it, which I think you could tie and just leave sort of like hanging long. The sleeve has this cool like little elastic moment because I like to push my sleeves up a little bit. Has a drop waist with this really pretty like pleat situation. And it's like a true maxi. I'll move back for you. So you can see it literally like hits the floor for me because, you know, I'm tall. Like, I feel like you can dress this up or down, and I'll show you kind of how I would do that. Okay, I got rid of the bow and just left it like a hanging tie. Added a denim jacket, and you guys, it's already chill. A white sneaker, and I can go hang out for brunch, go on kind of like a chill date. She's cute, right? It's a vibe. Like, hey, I'm just chilling, but I also look really, really, really freaking cute, and people are gonna be like, cute dress all day. So, win-win. Here's the second way I'd wear this, and it's probably more natural to my style. Added a fun hat. Added a blazer with this really cool check print. It's a navy blazer from Eloquy, but it also has red in it. So it's like a play on the red. It just, I don't know, I feel like this goes super, super well. And I'm kind of obsessed, and if you see this on Instagram, don't be surprised. Here's the second piece from Melissa. It's one of the sweatshirts I told you guys about. Huge, huge, huge fan. Like this applique, that's the word I was looking for before. Applique, we did it. Is so freaking cool. I'm obsessed. And I think, of course, a sweatshirt and jeans is cute, or even like a fun slouchy trouser, but I think it's fun to kind of pump in like just more color. And so I added my fave like chill green skirt that I wear like every day all the time. So yeah, it's just a fun little like element, wear it with sneakers or some booties, chilling. Moto jacket, jean jacket, whatever you feel, into it. I guess this video is friends first. The next indie designer that I'm gonna talk about is called KIN, and that is Miss Christine's new brand. She is such a doll. She was in my last vlog, I think, or the one before the last. She is another plus size influencer who has put her blood, sweat, and tears into starting her own line. It is such hard work. But Miss Christine is known for the bodycon skirts, the skinny jean. She does the form-fitting thing, and that is very much her style. So she gave me a skirt that I wanted to show you guys. This is so This is a skirt. It's in this gold color, and I'll walk up so that you can see my top has this fun color in it too. So gold on gold on gold. Nami? Just wanted to show you one more piece that Christine gave me. It is this curvy tee, super cute, C-R-V-Y. Yeah, so it's super cute, and I put on another indie designer, R.I.P. Prem. Prem was Gabby and Nicolette's line. I'm a forever fan of both of them as people and as the brand. But yeah, I just put this on top just to kind of play in the tonal vibes, you know? Designer is Universal Standard. Most of you have probably heard about them already. They market pretty intensely on Instagram, and a lot of people love the brand. They go from like size 00 to 40, probably the most size inclusive brand on the market, I would say. That's my guess. I got this sweater and skirt set. It's two pieces. See here. I live for this. Like, this is insane to me. The quality is unreal. I'm not worried about like janky knits, because I'm just, at this point in my life, I'm over janky knits. Like, I can't do it, won't do it, don't have to, not gonna, right? They feel so soft, so ready to swaddle my body. I love. Also, this color I feel like is virtually impossible to find in plus sizes. Like, I cannot find blue. Like, why are fat people not allowed to wear blue? Is there like a blue society for the thin? Like, what is happening? For me, this is an instant, like, yes, you can put on black booties and like a sleek jacket. I want to mix this with color. I feel like green would blow this outfit out of the water. So green booties and some like green accessories maybe. I don't know, but I feel like this color wants to be paired with blue, with green, and I'm gonna do it. Cannot be stopped. I'm going to be very honest. I'm a Sagittarius, so you already know you can trust what I say. We are truth tellers to a fault. I'm gonna be very honest. I'm almost teared up. This is the blazer that my fat arms has been looking for my entire life. Like, it is something so surreal. And it shouldn't be, but it is something so surreal to put on a blazer. And I have lots of blazers, but I'm so accustomed to the arm being a hair too small, like a hair, that I don't even feel it anymore. But when I put on this blazer, which is probably one of the best cut blazers I have ever worn at any price point, you know, your girl, like, when it comes to clothes, when I want what I want, it's not like price is no object. It's more just like I'm willing to invest in my wardrobe. I've spent so much money on blazers, and this is the one. This is the one. There's another brand, another indie brand, Henning, which I'm really excited to try their blazers. Another friend of mine, Lauren. But this is the jam. It's in that lightweight, which I feel like it's an all-year blazer. You can wear this thing January to December, and you are good. Now I don't know why I decided to put this blazer over a knit onesie. That I don't know. I mean, but here we are. But the way that I would wear this would be something kind of fun like this onesie. I like that it's like this oatmeal color. I like that there's a lot of texture happening. I don't know if you can see it, but the onesie has a lot of texture. And I would just put on like a classic sneaker, like my Stan Smiths, you know, keeping it light, keeping it chill. But I've been having a hankering for one particular style of dressing. I'm going to make a video about it because it is so random. You'll see, but I think you're gonna laugh and you're probably gonna love it. It's really classic and it's outside of my normal sort of like maximal approach. It's really pared down. I used to be super minimal, by the way. Go check those like 2016 blog posts. Your girl was like neutral, right? Neutrals. Clean silhouettes, clean lines, I was in it. But this blazer is amazing. Universal Standard, you nailed this like a mother. Like, and of course it does buttons, it's comfortable. I'm not gonna like hulk out of this thing. It's not stretchy, it's just perfectly made. It's impeccable, obsessed. here's the thing. I feel like a fairy tale creature in the best possible way. This dress is romance, fantasy, come away with me. I have it tied completely wrong. I will admit I suck at tying wrap dresses myself. I'm also wearing a bra that is the wrong bra, because you can see here, if I just had on a plunge bra instead of the t-shirt bra that I'm wearing, that wouldn't be showing. The cleavage is cleaving. The sleeves are sleeving. I'm obsessed. Are you kidding me? Do you see what's happening on my body? Okay, wait, sorry. Let's collect ourselves. Sorry, dress. I have literally the worst underwear on for this, but this is from a company that slid into my DMs. So many brands. This is not like a brag either. This is just a reality of the job that I do. So many brands hop in my DMs like, hey, I'm an indie designer, blah, blah, blah. Can we send you stuff? I'll go take a look at the website. Sometimes I'm like, thank you so much for reaching out and thinking of me. I don't think it's a fit, because it's not something that I know that I ever want to wear. Loud Bodies slid into my DMs and they were like, hey boo, can we send you something? Went to the website and I was like, yes, this and this. So, I'm like, look at me, I'm speechless. I love this. It's romantic and fun, but it's not costumey. You know what I'm saying? Like, put this on with another, like a trench over it for a little, you know, winter fantasy. We're going out, we're going to a party. We are, you know, we're chuckling with a martini glass in our hands. Ha 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 ha. We're doing all of that in this dress. Loud Bodies is based in the UK. They go from I think a 1X or a large to 5X, 6. I'm gonna double check. I'll fact check myself and put it on the screen. But you guys, I'm a lover. Remember this guy? It was in my Portland vlog. So many comments was, where's that dress from? On my Instagram, where's that dress from? It is from Loud Bodies. It is the autumnal magic you didn't know you needed. A head to toe plaid. Are you kidding me? Like a tartan sort of plaid too, with a little ruffly dupe on the sleeve. Peep the ruffly dupe. Wow. Wow. Also a maxi style. This dress is amazing. I'm so into Loud Bodies and I'm so glad they reached out, because now I have a new like fave to shop. They have tons of different things. Mostly dresses, I think. I could be wrong. Go to their website and check it out. And if head to toe plaid is a little scary for you, let me show you something. Well, look at what popping our new favorite blazer on does for this dress. Totally tones it down, but keeps the vibe. Like, it kind of adds something too, right? Like, we could do this blazer, we could do a moto jacket, we could do a trench coat, we could do a cardigan. Options are endless. I want to say thank you for watching. I want to say thank you for subscribing. I want to say thank you for rocking with me through my very frequent uploads and through my like every other week moments. You guys have been there for me and I appreciate you so much. Remember, Monday, Thursday, Sunday, it's me and you. We have a standing date. Mark it in your calendars, turn on the notifications, all of that good stuff. Thank you so much for watching. Love you, mean it. Bye.